Welcome to the University of Huddersfield, Graham.
Thank you.
What does it mean to you to receive the honorary doctorate today?
Oh, wow. It is, first of all, incredibly unexpected, but a real honour. It's been a real privilege to be the artistic director of Huddersfield Contemporary Music Festival for the last, this year will be my 18th festival. I thought I would do 3 years many years ago when I turned up to take the job. But, I've had such amazing support from the university throughout my time in the role, from the Vice Chancellor's office all the way through to colleagues in the music department and various departments in the university. And, the Contemporary Music Festival has got such a worldwide reputation, you know, that we managed to keep building on, which is fantastic. So it's a wonderful personal honour to receive the honorary doctorate and the award. But I also hope that I can use it to further the ambitions of HCMF. And as I said in the hall, I never went to university. I've had a very long and varied career path to being here. And I also hope that it can inspire other people who maybe didn't go to university, that it's achievable, what's achievable. And, because I've had such a wide and varied career path in becoming the director here, I always say to people that a career is many things, many paths that take different directions, and, always there to dream and always there to imagine what you might do next.
As you've touched on, you're the Artistic Director and Chief Executive for the Huddersfield Contemporary Music Festival, or as we commonly call it, HCMF, and you have been since 2006. How has this global festival changed and developed over the years? You must have seen quite some changes.
Yeah, quite a few. I think that the one big change maybe we've made in my time was to, the festival had a huge market profile worldwide, but perhaps it brought a lot of work to the UK. And I think one change we've made, which I hope is of a huge benefit to the many artists and musicians who were there to support, is that we become much more a producer of work, and taking work now around Europe, co-producing, co-commissioning with other festivals around the world, and touring work around the world. And I think that's so important because I think, very often a lot of contemporary music performances, pieces that are written by composers, they're performed once, twice, and we have to create a new repertoire, and we have to let the work live and breathe. And, that's been one major change, that we're now seen as producers and commissioners of new music and touring that around the world. And also taking the work, I think, further afield, not just Europe, but doing these little bespoke festivals, in other countries, such as we've done two in Mexico City, we've done one in Beirut, we've done one in Philadelphia, we've done one in Rio. We're now talking about doing one in Bangkok and one in Indonesia. So again, it's taken, artistic practice from the UK to different countries, different cultures, but it's also taken the name of Huddersfield around the world as well. So that's one of the major changes, I'd say. We're now producers of work and tour that work.
As someone who's had a long and successful career, are there any particular figures in your life that have inspired you?
Oh, many people have inspired me. Many artists, many composers. One of the great things about this job is that, I've had the chance to work with artists, some of them I would call friends, that, I just would be a huge fan of anyway. And that's really nice to learn a lot more about how they approach their art. But apart from that, before I got involved in the arts, I was mainly involved in social work, from working with homeless people in a shelter to doing all sorts of family casework and welfare rights. And some of the most inspiring people that I've come across in my life were people who had a difficult start in life and had to overcome adversity. And I think that taught me very early on, you know, really to look for the potential in everybody. And that's what I try and do, that's what I try and follow. So, you know, in terms of inspiration, you know, I could quote lots of people you'll never have heard of, but they're the people who really inspired my approach to life.
And finally, as someone who has mentored for a range of organisations, if you could give one piece of advice to our students, what would it be?
You know, a lot of the mentoring starts with time management. You know, really try and think about what you want to do short term, medium term, where you want to get to. Look at the things you're currently doing and ask yourself, are they helping me get there? And if not, then think about what will. So that would be one thing, I think, with a lot of mentoring. You know, a lot of it's also about confidence. And I always say to artists, you know, a lot of artists say to me, like, well, you know, I didn't send you this idea or I didn't contact you because I don't want to come across as a nuisance, you know. And I always say to them, look, you know, a festival at HCMF is only as good as the ideas that artists bring forward. You are the lifeblood of the art forum, you know. So really, you know, that's the wrong way around to think you're going to bother me by sending me a proposal or asking if you can have a chat or whatever, you know. So that's the other thing I'd say. And actually, I really enjoy mentoring. I think, you know, you can tell by the grey beard, I'm getting a little older. And, you know, it'll only be a few years before no one will listen to me anyway. So while I'm in this position and I get to sound off and I get to be opinionated, then mentoring is a good way to do it.